Good afternoon. In the name of Jesus Christ, we commence afternoon Bible study.
大家午安，我们奉主耶稣圣名开始下午的查经聚会。
Please bow and pray in silence.
请起低头默祷。
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. In the name of Christ, we commence afternoon Bible study. Let's all rise and sing hymn 151.
哈利路亚，奉主耶稣圣名，我们开始下午的查经聚会，请起立唱诗153首。
151。
151首。
Praise and thank God. Before our Bible study, let's all kneel down and pray and ask the Heavenly Father guide us.
那在我们开始下午的查经聚会之前，我们起跪下来祷告，求天父的带领。
Please kneel down and pray together.
请起跪下来祷告。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Good afternoon to all of you.
各位，我午安。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we commence afternoon Bible study.
奉主耶稣圣名，我们开始下午的查经聚会。
So this afternoon we continue to study a quiver full of arrows.
那今天下午我们要继续来学习充满箭的箭袋。
Let's turn to the book of Psalms 127, verse 4 and verse 5.
请翻开诗篇127篇第四节和第五节。
Psalms 127, verse 4 and verse 5.
诗篇127篇第四节第五节。
Verse 4.
第四节。
Like arrows in the hand of a warrior, so are the children of one's youth. Verse 5.
第五节。
Happy is the man who has quiver full of them. They should not be ashamed, but shall speak with the enemies in the gate.So we spent the first two sessions talking about children are a heritage from the Lord.
那我们前面呢两节聚会呢我们谈到儿女是主所赐的产业。
But I say here in verse 4, like arrows in the hand of a warrior, so are the children of one's youth.
那这里谈到少年时所生的儿女好像勇士手中的箭。
Actually, for me, I'm always very intrigued with bow and arrows.
那对我来说呢
Bow and arrows, yeah.
The 弓跟箭
I remember when I was in high school, I loved to use arrows.
那我记得我在高中的时候，我很喜欢使用弓和箭
And quite often when I watch movies and there's some warriors who use bow and arrows, I always feel, you know, that they are my favorite characters.
那很多时候在电影当中看到一些勇士，他们使用弓箭，那他们就会成为我最喜欢的角色。
So I read up a little bit on, you know, what kind of material do people use for arrows? What kind of wood do people use for arrows?
那所以呢，我就借此来查看一下，人们使用什么样的材料来制作这个箭。
And it's interesting, they, you know, for good arrows, they use three different kinds of woods.
那很有趣的是要制作一个好的箭呢他们会使用三种材料。
The first one is birch. Right? Birch wood is hard and is very tough and it's white, it's light in color.
那第一种所使用的 木材呢它是非常坚韧的。
And interesting, you can find a lot of this wood in New England, especially Maine and New Hampshire and Vermont.
那很特别的是这样的材料呢可以在新英格兰特别是在缅因州那个地区可以找得到。
And another kind of wood they use is Port Oxford cedar, which is light and also very straight but a little bit soft.
那第二种材料呢是一种香柏木那它的材质稍微比较软一点。
And because it makes out of cedar, the aroma smells very good, especially when you put in aquiver of your bag, and then when people walk behind you and stuff, they can smell the aroma because it's cedar.
那你使用这样的材料呢，它的味道很香，所以如果你把它放在你背后的箭袋，别人经过的时候会闻到这个很香的气味。
Because you can find a lot of cedar in the West Coast in the United States.
那你在过去可以在西岸找到很多这样的材料。
But the third type of wood that people use is the Norway pine. Norway pine.
那第三种材料是一种杉木，挪威的杉木。
And you can find all these kind of pine in the Baltic Sea forests.
那你可以在一个特别的森林里面找到这样的材料。
So out of those three different kind of woods, but there's two type of arrows.
那在这三种材料之下呢，可以有两种的箭。
Can you show the picture, please? The first arrow we call the self arrow.
那第一种呢是叫做就是是有一块木头所制作成的。
Yeah, if you see the picture on there, actually the self arrow is on the right, and there's a second kind of arrow is the footed arrow is on the left.
那如果各位可以看到画面上呢，在右边呢就是所谓只是用一种木头制作成，然后另外旁边呢是另外一种
And you notice.You notice that the self arrow on the right has one color throughout.
那如果各位看到画面上面呢，这种右手边的这个剑呢，它只有一种颜色，整个剑只有一种颜色。
So in other words, that they just you know, use a piece of wood and they use you know they don't put anything else except for that same wood for arrows.
那他们制作这样的剑，他只会用一块木材来制作。
But you notice the picture on the left is talking about the footed arrows.
那在画面的左手边呢，是另外一种footed 的剑。
And you notice they have different colors.
那大家可以注意到它有不同的颜色。
And the reason why they have different colors because they have inlay of different kind of woods inside those wood.
那它之所以有不同的颜色，是因为呢，它是用不同的木材把它制作而成的。
But what's interesting that the footed arrows work effectively for warriors, for hunters, because they are very strong and they can make it very straight.
那很有趣的是，这种用不同木材一起做成的这个剑呢，被勇士还有猎人所利用，因为它非常的有功效，很强，很。
So when I was thinking about these two kinds of different arrows, I was thinking about also our children is also the same thing.
那当我看到这两种不同的箭头的时候，我就想到我们的自己的儿女。
No, some children they just like the self arrows. They are born, they are naturally, you know, diligent. They are very, you know, they are very self motivated. All these things themselves.
那有一些孩子呢，他们天生呢就是很勤奋，然后他们会很主动、很愿意的去学习。
But we know most children, they like the footed arrows. They need a lot of inlay, right, to make them work effectively, especially when it comes to the Word of God.
那但是呢，很多时候，大部分的孩子呢，他们都是需要很多不同的一些支持，然后呢，来让他们做学习，特别是在学习神的话上面。
And you can see, right, if you have four or five different children, they all their personalities are very different.
那如果我们有四五个孩子，我们可以看到他们每一个人都有独特的个性。
Some is very self-motivated.
那有一些人呢，他们有很高的意志。
But some are very lazy.
那但是有一些人呢，他们是懒惰的。
And some you can just tell them one thing, and you know, one time they just do it.
那有一些呢，你可以告诉他一件事情一次，那他就会去做。
But some you can tell them 10-20 times. They still don't want to listen.
但是有另外一些孩子呢，或许同样的事告诉他们许许多多次，但他们还是不会听。
So that's why when you and I have a quiver full of these arrows, it's so important for us to make sure, you know, we put a lot of inlay in those arrows so they can work appropriately and correctly.
所以当我们的箭袋充满这样的箭的时候，我们要确保我们给他们很多的支持，所以他们能够很有效的来发挥他们的功用。
So what does this mean for you and I?
那这对我们来说是什么意思呢？
We have to train our children.
我们必须要教养我们的孩童。
Of course, different cultures train our children very differently.
那当然在不同的文化背景之下有不同的教养方式。
And from generation to generation also train our children differently.
那在不同的世代也有不同的教养方式。
Let's go to the Bible and see what is the scripture teaching when it comes to you know, teach our children.
那我们现在就回到圣经，看看在这个圣经当中对要教导我们怎么样来教养孩子。
Let's go to Deuteronomy chapter 6.
请看生命记第六章。
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 1 to verse 9.
生命记第六章第一节到第九节。
We can break this into two different parts.
那我们可以把这一大段的经文分成两个部分。
The first part is verse 1 to verse 3.
第一个部分是从第一节到第三节。
And the second part is verse 4 to verse 9.
那第二个部分从第四节到第九节。
Actually, both parts are very important to raise our children and to teach our children.
那这两个部分对于我们要教养孩童都是非常重要的。
Because this is Bible study, let's read these verses together.
那因为我们下午是查经的聚会，所以让我们一起来读这些经文。
So from verse 1 to verse 3, for those of us who are parents, let's pay very close attention to this teaching.
那从第一节到第三节，对于我们这些做父母的，让我们特别注意这几节经节。
Then from verse 4 to verse 9.
那从第四节到第九节。
For those of us who are training our children, or we are children ourselves, we must pay close attention to this.
那对于那些我们在教养孩童上，或者是作为儿女的，我们要特别注意这一段。
Let's go to chapter 6, verse 1.
我们请看到第六章的第一节。
Now this is the commandment, and these are the statutes and judgments which the Lord God has commanded to teach you, that you may observe them in the land which you are crossing over to possess. Verse 2.
第二节。
That you may fear the Lord your God, to keep all his statutes and his commandments which I commanded you, you and your son and your grandson, all the days of your life, and that your days may be prolonged. Verse 3.
第三节。
Therefore, hear, O Israel, and be careful to observe it, that it may be well with you, and that you may multiply greatly, as the Lord God of your fathers has promised you, a land flowing with milk and honey. Let's study these first three verses first.
那我们首先先来一起查考这前面的三节。
Here the Lord say, now this is the commandment, and these are the statutes and judgment which the Lord God has commanded to teach you, that you may be observed them in the land which you are crossing over to possess.
那这里谈到，这是主你们神所吩咐教训你们的诫命、律例、典章，使你们在所要过去得为业的地上遵行。
Now, as parents, if we want to teach our children, we ourselves need to be taught by the Lord.
那我们作为父母，如果我们想要教养我们的儿女，我们也必须要来学习神的诫命。
If you and I as parents do not observe the commandment of the Lord or the statutes of the Lord, then it's very difficult to teach our children.
如果我们作为父母的没有来遵行神的诫命跟律例的话，那我们很难能够来教养我们的儿女。
That's why it's so important to observe the teaching of the Lord so our children can see us doing it so they also can follow.
那所以我们借由我们遵行神的诫命、律例、典章，我们的儿女看到我们，他们同样也能够来遵行神的诫命。
Not only that you and I should learn to observe the Lord teaching, but also to fear the Lord, just like in verse 2, that you may fear the Lord your God.
那我们不单单只是要遵守神的诫命，也要像第二节谈到的，我们要敬畏主我们的神。
Of course, sometimes when we as parents, if we don't follow God's teaching, if we don't fear the Lord, then we cannot expect our children also to do the same.
那我们作为父母的，如果我们没有遵守神的诫命，我们没有敬畏神，那我们很难期待我们的儿女也会这样的来做。
For example, now that we are quarantined to our own homes, what do we do during Sabbath?
那一个例子就是，当我们在都在居家隔离的时候，在安息日的时候，我们做什么呢
？And what do we do every day that we have time off？
那当我们有空闲时间的时候，我们每天都在做什么呢
？Do we take the time to read the Bible together？ Do we take the time to pray together with our children？
我们是不是有花时间和我们的儿女一起来读经，一起来祷告呢
？Or do we ourselves？Read the scriptures and praying so our children can see this is our devotion, this is our worship toward God.
那或者是我们自己有没有花这些时间读经祷告，然后让我们的儿女可以看到呢？
You know, even though we feel sometimes our children are very young, it doesn't seem that they pay too much attention to us, but actually, in reality, they'll pay attention to every little things that you and I do.
那很多时候我们或许认为我们的儿女年纪还小，并没有注意到我们在做什么，但事实上呢，他们其实观察到我们所做的每一件事情。
If we look in verse 3,
如果我们看第三节，
Say, therefore, hear, O Israel, and be careful to observe it, that it may be well with you, and that you may multiply greatly, as the Lord God of your fathers has promised you, a land flowing with milk and honey.
第三节，以色列啊，你要听，要谨守遵行，使你可以在那流奶与蜜之地得以享福，人数极其增多，正如主你列祖的神所应许你的。
Now to observe and follow God's commandment is not for the unbelievers.
那要来遵守遵行神的诫命，并不是对那些不信的人来说的。
But these are for you and I. We are the spiritual Israelites nowadays.
但是我们今日就是这些以色列人。
Just learn the time, you know, during that time, God just worry or care about His people, you know, the chosen people, to observe everything that He says.
那就好像那个时候，神他在意，他关心担忧那些属于他的人。
But what is interesting to me is the end of verse 3 say that, you know, that, O Israel, and be careful to observe it,that it may be well with you, and that you may multiply greatly. Multiply greatly. What is that going to do with observing God's teaching, and multiplying?
那对我来说很有趣的是，在第三节谈到以色列啊，你要听，要谨守遵行，然后接着谈到他们的人数就会极其增多。那谨守遵行神的诫命和人数增多有什么关系呢？
And what observing God's command have to do with a land flowing with milk and honey?
那谨守遵行神的诫命和那流奶与蜜之地又有什么样的关联呢？
You know, when you and I follow the teaching of our Lord Jesus Christ,
当我们遵行我们主耶稣基督的命令的时候，
we'll be blessed, no, we'll be blessed upon, you know, blessing upon blessings.
那我们会得到满意的福气。
If you and I can truly observe the commandments of the Lord,
如果我们可以真正真的来谨守遵行神的命
令， then it's very easy for us to preach to others and to teach our children to also come to know the Lord.
那对于我们要向别人传福音，或者是教养我们的孩童来遵守神的诫命是很容易的。
And when you and I observe the commandment of the Lord,
当我们谨守遵行神的诫命的时候，
really, it's just like heaven on earth.
那我们就会过着好像在地如天的生活。
No, our homes, our situation will be like a place, a land flowing with milk and honey.
那我们的家或者是我们所处的环境就会好像流奶与蜜之地。
And it all has to do with our faith.
那这一切呢，都和我们的信心有关系。
Because the greatest thing that God can, you know, that God has given to us is our free choice, our free will.
那神所赐给我们最好的事情，就是我们有自由的意志。
No, He wants to multiply us. He wants to bless us with milk and honey.
那神想要我们的人数增多，他也想要让我们能够享受流奶与蜜之地。
But before we can receive these blessings, you and I need to follow His teachings.
但是在我们能够享受这些祝福之前，我们必须要遵行神的诫命。
So for you and I as parents, it's so important to be able to follow the first three verses.
所以对于我们做父母的人来说，要能够遵行这前面三节所谈到的经文是很重要的。
If we ourselves as parents cannot observe the teaching of the Lord Jesus Christ, then it's very difficult to go to verse 4 to verse 9.
如果我们作为父母的没有办法遵守神跟耶稣的诫命的话，那接下来的四节以后就很难做到了。
Because these are the teaching that you and I must teach our children,But we only can do that if you and I ought to have learned from the Lord ourselves.
因为这些教训是我们要教导儿女的，但是我们也要先遵行，所以我们才能够来教养我们的儿女。
Let's go to verse 4.
我们请再继续看第四节。
Let's read verse 4 to verse 9 together.
那我们一起读第四节到第九节。
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4 to verse 9.
生命记第六章第四节到第九节。
Verse 4.
第四节。
Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Verse 5.
第五节。
You shall love the Lord with all, you shall love the Lord, your God, with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. Verse 6.
第六节。
And these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. Verse 7.
第七节。
You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. Verse 8.
第八节。
You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be as frontlets between your eyes. Verse 9.
第九节。
You shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. So we can see from verse 4 to verse 9, after we have learned and follow the word of our Lord Jesus Christ, and then we can teach this to our children.
所以我们看到从第四节到第九节，就是在我们遵行神的诫命之后，我们可以将这些来教导我们的儿女。
Look at verse 4.
请看第四节。
Say, Hear Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one.
以色列啊，你要听，主我们神是独一的主。
And some translations say, the Lord God, He is the only one.
那有一些翻译谈到主我们的神是唯一的主。
So let's look at here, say, Hear, O Israel.
那这里谈到以色列啊，你要听。
Now, quite often before Moses talked to the people, God commanded him to say, Hear, O Israel.
那很多时候当神叫摩西宣讲道理的时候，他会要他说：“以色列啊，你要听。”
Why is it so important for Moses to remind the chosen people they are the Israelites?
那对为什么对于摩西要来提醒以色列百姓是神的选民如此的重要呢？
Because during a time, even though there's millions of people on earth,
因为在那个时候，就算地上有数以百万计的人，
but only the Israelites were the chosen people of God.
但是只有以色列民，他们是神的选民。
So they need to realize that to live their lives very differently to other people in the nation.
所以他们必须要有这样的认识了解，那他们才可以活出和地上其他的人不一样的生活。
They must know that inside their heart, so they can teach that to their children.
他们在他们的心中必须要有这样的认识，所以他们才能够来教导他们的儿女。
So the same thing for us nowadays.
那对于今天的我们来说也是一样。
We have to understand that you and I are Christians. You and I are believers of our Lord Jesus Christ.
我们是基督徒，我们是神的选民。
And the way we do things are very different than people of the world.
那我们在生活当中的所言所行和世界上其他的人是要不一样的。
You know, people in the world, they can lie very easily.
那在这个世界上的人，他们很容易就可以撒谎。
They can steal things without, you know, their conscience rebuking them.
那他们甚至可以偷窃，但是他们的良心不会谴责他们。
They can commit so many sins in the world, you know, without knowing what is right and what is wrong.
他们也可以犯了很多的罪，但是他们却不能够分辨是非。
But if you and I live that kind of life, and then we realize that actually we do not know and realize that we are the Israelites.
那如果我们也过着这样的生活的话，那我们就没有办法认识到我们也是以色列人。
That you and I are the chosen people of God.
我们是神的选民。
We are His holy nation.
我们是圣洁的国度。
We are His royal priesthood.
我们是有君尊的祭司。
We are His special people.
我们是他特别拣选的。
So that's why, you know, before we can teach our children, this wisdom, this knowledge must be not only in our minds, but also in our hearts, so we can teach our children correctly.
所以在我们要能够正确的教养我们的孩童之前，我们必须不只在我们的脑中，在我们的心里也要有这样的认识。
If you and I do not know that we are Christians,
那如果我们不知道我们是基督徒，
then we would never know what is the most important part in our lives.
那我们就没有办法了解在我们生命当中最重要的部分是什么。
Like for the Israelites.
就像这些以色列民一样。
So after they hear Israel, the Lord God, the Lord is the only one, this means that if they know the Israelite, then there's only one thing that is important to them, that is the true and living God.
那就像这个经节说，以色列啊，你要听主，我们神是独一的主。如果他们认识到他们是以色列民，那他们就只有一个最重要的事要认识，就是主是他们独一的神。
So the same thing for us.
那对我们来说也是一样。
If we do not know that we are Christians,
如果我们不了解我们是基督徒，
then we will live our life exactly like the people in the world.
那我们就会活过着一个像世界上的人一样的生活。
Really, what are the goals for the people who live in the world?
那到底在这个世界上的人，他们所有的目标是什么呢？
Maybe fame, glory, power, money, all of these things.
那他们所追求的可能是名声，可能是荣誉，可能是财富这些事情。
But of course, it's nothing wrong to have all those things.
当然拥有这些并不是什么错事。
But that's not our goals as Christians.
但是我们作为基督徒，这些并不是我们的目标。
Our goal as Christian is to understand that God is number one in our lives.
我们作为基督徒的目标应该是要了解神是在我们生命当中最重要的。
Anything that you and I put before God and become a great idol in our life.
那在我们生活当中任何事情，如果我们把它摆在神之前的话，这些事情就会成为我们的偶像。
If you and I know that we are Christians,
那如果我们认识到我们是基督徒，
then our purpose, our goal actually is very different than the people is in the world.
那我们的目标，我们所追求的，就会和这个世界上的人不相一样。
Thank God, I mean, I have an opportunity to live here in Texas.
那感谢神，我有机会能够住在德州。
I have met so many nice Christian people out there.
那我在这遇到了很多很好的基督徒。
And the reason why they're so kind, so nice, because of course they are Christian. They live a life, you know, according to God's will. They live a life to do, you know, what is best to glorify God's name.
那他们之所以这样善良，是因为呢，他们要过着一个让神喜悦，是按照神旨意的生活。
I remember when my nephew was, you know, living with me.
那我记得当我的侄子和我住在一起的时候。
And then he got in trouble in school.
那他在学校惹了一些麻烦。
And then the teacher and the principal called us, you know, my wife and I, to talk about his situation.
那学校老师校长就打电话给我和我的太太来谈论这个情形。
And what impressed me the most that for them, the grades, his grades were not that important. What they're saying that we really want this young man to grow up to be a good person. So his character had been changed the last several months and we are worried. And I was so impressed when they say that.
那他们电话当中就谈到说，让我印象最深刻的是，他们说成绩对于这个年轻这个小伙子来说并不是最重要，但是我们希望他可以长大成为一个很好的人。
So,
所以过去几个月他的行为有一些改变，我们很担忧。
Because you know, for them as Christian, they care about people characteristic or characters more than just you know grades and things like that. And I was very touched by that.
那他们认为他们作为基督徒对他们来说他们的一个人的品性更比他们的成绩还要更重要。那这对我来说是让我很感动的。
Then in verse 5 it says here.
所以在第五节这里谈到。
Deuteronomy chapter 6 verse 5.
生命记第六章第五节。
It says, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart.We say here, you shall love your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength.
第五节，你要尽心、尽性、尽力爱主你的神。
This is what God, you know, demands from us.
那这是神对我们的命令。
We know who we are.
我们知道我们是谁。
We know what is the most important thing in our life is.
那我们也知道在我们生命当中最重要的是什么。
Now we must love, right, the most important things in our life.
那我们现在要做的就是尽力的来爱这个我们生命中最重要的。
But we don't just love, you know, with insincerity or very shallow, but we must love with our totality.
那但是我们的这个爱并不是只是很肤浅的，而是要尽我们的全心全力去爱。
The first thing said, you should love the Lord your God with all your heart.
那第一个部分谈到你要尽心的爱主你的神。
Our heart is, you know, is when you talk about love, you always talk about our heart.
那当我们谈论到爱的时候，我们总是会谈到我们的心。
Because our heart would make the whole body become alive because it pumps all the blood through our whole system, so you and I become a living being.
那我们的心是造就我们成为一个活人的，因为当心脏跳动，它让血液传输到全身。
So when we love God with all our heart,
所以当我们尽心来爱我们的神
，It means our love is not complacent, our love is not inactive, our love actually is very active and is very zealous, right? We just, you know, is very active in loving Jesus.
所以当我们谈到这样的爱的时候，并不是很被动的，而是一种主动、很热忱、积极的爱。
So we also have to love God with all our soul.
那同样，我们也要尽兴的来爱我们的神。
Of course, soul has to do with our emotion, right? The way, you know, the way we do things, the way we look at things is very important.
那这里谈到尽兴，我们的灵魂是要这谈到是跟我们的情绪、情感有关的。
Then we must love God with all our strength.
那接着谈到，我们也要尽力来爱我们的神。
Of course, another part, another verse say you must love God with all our mind.
那另外的经节也有谈到，我们要尽
心 all our mind, maybe with all our mind, yeah.
我们全部的心智来爱我们的神。
No, for example, when we love a person, we must have action, and that action will take a lot of strength.
那比如说当我们爱一个人的时候我们会付出行动那这个行动是需要花费力气的。
And a lot of time when you love a person, it need action, that action need to have a lot of thinking.
那当我们爱一个人我们付出行动的时候我们也要把很多的想法放在其中。
Now, for example, if I say, you know, I love my wife very much.
那比如说如果我说我非常的爱我的太太。
And at night time when she's hungry and she tell me, Rudy can go downstairs and get me something to eat.
那如果晚上她跟我说 Rudy 我现在肚子很饿你可以到楼下为我拿一点食物吗
I tell her, I love you very much, but please do it yourself.
但是如果我回答她说哦我很爱你可是请你自己去拿食物。
That doesn't make sense, right? It doesn't make sense, right?
那这样子的话就跟我所表达的不相符了。
So when you and I love God with our totality, this means,Whatever necessary, like for us to, you know, to please God, to glorify His name, that's what you and I must do.
所以当我们宣称我们是尽我们的全心全力来爱主的时候，我们就要做任何一切可以讨主喜悦的事。
And that's why in verse 6 say, and these words, why in verse 6?
所以在第六节谈到。
And these words, which I command you today, shall be in your heart.
我今日所吩咐你的话都要记在心上。
Actually, you know, our heart is so important to love God and to love mankind.
那我们的心对于我们要爱人或爱神都是很重要的。
So now let's think about this. Do you and I truly have the word of God inside our hearts?
所以现在让我们再来思考，我们在我们的心上是不是真的有存记神的话语呢
？If we don't have the word of God inside our hearts,
如果在我们的心里没有神的话
，then we cannot go to the next step.
那我们就没有办法再进到下一步。
That is to teach our children.
那就是要来教训我们的儿女。
And that's why I think one of the, I guess, one of the things that is very burdensome as the work of God.
那所以作为神的工人有的时候我们是有担负很多重担的。
That my family must see Jesus in me.
那我的家人必须在我身上看到耶稣。
But not only in my mind, but also inside my heart.
那并不是只是在我的意志上面 也要在我的心中。
So when they see me, you know, doing things, saying things, do I say it with love and compassion, with grace?
那当他们看到我的所言所行是不是都是出于爱和怜悯的呢
And every decision I have, every decision that I'm making, am I, you know, following the word of God, which is inside my heart?
那我所做的每一个决定是不是都由我心里面所存神的意志 来做的决定呢
If you and I have the word of God inside our heart,
所以你我如果有神的话在我们的心中
Now is the right time to teach our children these words.
那现在就是一个很好的时机来教训我们的儿女
And because the word of God is inside our hearts,
那因为神的话在我们心中
And when you and I teach it,
当我们教养儿女的时候
We are teaching with love and grace and mercy.
我们会用爱，会用恩典，会用怜悯来教导他们。
Look at verse 7.
请看第七节。
Verse 7.
第七节。
You shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up.
也要殷勤教训你的儿女，无论你坐在家里，行在路上，躺下起来，都要谈论。
So when is, where is the best place to teach your children?
所以在什么地方是最好的可以教养儿女的地方呢?
And when is the best time to teach your children?
那什么时候是最好可以教养儿女的时机呢?
I say here, you shall teach them diligently to your children, and shall talk of them when you sit in your house.
那这里谈到要殷勤教训你的儿女，无论你坐在家里。
Actually, this is the best environment actually to teach our children when they are sitting with you in your house.
那所以最好的可以教养儿女的环境就是当他们和你一起坐在家里的时候。
But what are you and I doing when we are sitting?
那当我们坐着的时候我们在做什么呢?
Are we sitting to talk to our family?
我们是不是坐下来和我们的家人聊天呢?
Are we sitting you know, to read the scriptures?
我们坐下来是不是一起来读圣经呢?
Are we sitting to watch TV? Are we sitting, you know, to complain and to grumble?
或者是我们坐下只是在看电视或甚至在发出不满或抱怨呢?
It says here, say you shall talk of them when you sit in your house.
这里谈到我们要教训儿女是坐在家里的时候。
You know, quite often when you and I are sitting down, we want to relax, right? We don't want to teach our children.
那很多时候当我们坐下的时候我们只是想要放轻松我们并不想要来做教养的事情。
But during the time that you and I are at rest and our children are at rest, this is the best time to converse with them.
但是当我们和儿女都是在很轻松的状态之下的时候其实是最好的教养的时刻。
No, sometimes when we talk to our children, we only talk to them when we have something to yell at them about.
很多时候当我们要跟儿女谈话的时候都是在我们有事情要来责骂斥责他们的时候。
Oh, we have, you know, sometimes when you talk to them, when you ask them to do something.
或者是当我们有事情要他们去做的时候是我们跟他们谈论的时候。
But actually, we should spend most of our time talking to them, just talking, not because of any other reasons behind it.
但是我们要做的应该是就是花时间和他们来谈话而背后不应该有存在其他的原因。
And also say here, when you walk by the way.
那这里也谈到当我们行在路上。
Of course, walking is a little bit different than sitting.
那当然在行路的时候和坐着是有一些不同。
But when you and I are walking to different places,
当我们行路到不同的地方
，especially you know we walk into the heavenly kingdom，
啊，特别是我们谈到当我们在行走要到天国的时候
，Are we be able to teach our children？
我们是不是能够来教养我们的儿女呢
？When we are walking, are we walking on the right path？
当我们行走的时候，我们是不是走在正确的路上
？And when you and I are walking, are we walking toward the heavenly kingdom？
当我们在行走的时候，我们是不是朝着天国的方向前进呢
？Or we just lost and we walk on any path and we don't even know where we're going to go, what our destinations are.
或者是我们行路却是迷失方向，我们甚至不知道我们要到什么地方去呢
？And you, if you and I walk in such a way, and then there's no way that our children can follow us, can learn from us.
那如果我们是这样的在行路的话，那我们的儿女就没有办法来。跟着我们，或者从我们身上有所学习。
The next one say when you lie down.
那接下来谈到躺下。
It's quite often when we are laying down, we don't want anybody to disturb us. Why you are resting? You're feeling nice, feeling good. Why do you want to teach your children?
那很多时候，当我们躺下的时候，我们是很轻松的在那里休息，我们并不想要受到其他的人的干扰。
Now when even when a person has sleep, you can tell a lot about them.
那甚至是当一个人在睡觉的时候，你可以观察到很多关于这个人。
For example, sometimes people lie down, they fall asleep right away.
那比如说有一些人一躺下很快就可以睡着。
And some people even though they're lying down but they cannot be at rest, they're always full of anxieties.
那但是有另外一些人呢，他们虽然是躺下，但是他们却没有办法好好的休息，因为他们充满了很多焦虑。
Of course, sometimes when people lie down, you know, when they sleep, they snore, they make a lot of weird noises with their mouth, right?
那有一些人呢，他们躺下睡觉的时候，他们会很大声的打呼。
So when our children see us lying down, do they see us, you know, we lie down just like an angel, right? Very peaceful, very joyful, and they would love just to come lie next to us.
那当我们的儿女看到我们躺下的时候，他们是不是看到我们是很平静的，好像天使一样，所以他们也想要来躺在我们身边呢？
Of course, we must teach them also when you rise up.
那当然我们在起来的时候也要教导人。
So what is God is telling us is that we have to teach our children, right, in all different places, in every time and every situations.
所以在这里神告诉我们的就是我们无论在什么样的情况，在任何的时机，我们都要来教养我们的儿女。
It doesn't matter if we are sitting.
那无论我们是坐着。
It doesn't matter if we are walking.
无论我们是行在路上
，It doesn't matter if we are laying down.
那无论我们是躺下
，It doesn't matter if we rise up. We have to teach our children in all different circumstances.
那或者是我们在起来的时候，无论在什么样的情况之下，我们都要来教导我们的人。
In other words, we should never keep our guard down. In every situation, we know our children is observing.We must even sleeping, even sitting, even we are walking, rising up, make sure we do it according to the will of God.
所以我们无论在什么样的情况，即便是躺下来，在任何情况之下，我们都要来教导我们的儿女。
And look at verse 8.
那我们再请看第八节。
And verse 8.
第八节。
You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they should be as frontlets between your eyes.
也要系在手上为记号，戴在额上为经文。
This is also very important to teach our children.
那这个也是在教养儿女上面很重要的一点。
Because teaching others is not only by words, but also by our action.
因为当我们在教养的时候，不单单只是靠着言语，也要有行动。
So the word of God should also be the thing that binds on our hand.
所以神的话也要能够系在我们的手上。
Now, whatever we do with our hands, it should follow by the word of God, so we can teach our children when we do things with our hands, we also follow God's teaching, follow God's commandment.
所以无论我们在做什么，我们都要按着神的旨意来做，就好像我们在教导我们的儿女也是一样。
And this, I think, is more difficult, you know, more difficult than just, you know, teaching our children with words.
那我想这个比我们单单只用言语来教导儿女还要来困难。
Quite often as parents, we do not do what we say, you know, or we don't do the things that we tell our children that we would do.
那很多时候我们身为父母，我们并没有做到我们用言语告诉我们儿女所要做的事。
But if we look at young people, they learn a lot by observing.
但是如果我们看看很多的年轻的他们都是借由观察 来学习的。
Maybe quite often, actually, they, you know, they don't learn as good when we are talking to them, but they learn, you know, very well when they see what we do in our lives.
那很多时候，他们借由我们的话，并没有办法学到这么多，但是他们借由观察他们所见到的，他们可以学习的更好。
And not only that, we must, you know, put the word of God.No, the frontlets between our eyes.
那不单如此，我们还要把经文戴在我们的额上。
I don't know if you ever have a broken nose before, but when you have broken nose or swells up, you cannot see because the nose will be in front of your eyes.
我不晓得各位的鼻子有没有受伤过，因为如果有这样的情况的话，你其实没有办法看得很清楚，因为那鼻子好像就在你的眼前一样。
Of course, I mean you can see I have a very big forehead, right?
那各位可以看到我有很大的额头。
I can write a lot of stuff on my forehead.
我可以在我的额头上写很多的东西。
But some people have shorter forehead, you cannot write as much.
那有一些人的额头可能比较窄小，那只能写一些东西。
But whatever it is, you and I must write the word of God on our frontlets, right, our forehead, so that every time that you and I see something, we see through the filter from the word of God.
但是无论如何，我们要将神的经文在写在我们的额上，所以当我们看到彼此的时候，我们可以看到神的话。
Now, for example, you know, the situation with this coronavirus.
那例如说，现在我们处在这个新冠病毒的情况之中。
How do we see it?
那我们要怎么来看待呢？
Do we see it with the filters of God's word before, you know, we look at things?
那如果我们把这个神的话当成一个滤镜，然后从这样来看出去的话。
And not only pertain to this coronavirus, but pertain to everything in our life.
那不单单只是我们如何看待这个病毒的事情，还有我们要怎么样来看待我们生活当中的每一件事情。
The way we look at money.
那我们怎么样来看待钱财。
The way we look at education.
我们怎么样看待教育。
The way we look, you know, what is the most important thing in our lives. All these things, actually, we look through our eyes, but must be filtered by the word of God.
那甚至我们不论看什么样的事情，我们都要以神的话作为指标，然后借从此 来看出去。
Then the last thing is in verse 9.
那最后一个在第九节。
Verse 9.
第九节。
You shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates.
又要写在你房屋的门框上，并你的城门上。
Of course, doorposts are closer to your front door than the gates of your house.
那当然，门框比起城门是更接近你的房屋。
When our neighbors walk in front of our house,
当我们的邻居经过我们的房屋的时候
，most often they cannot see what's inside our house.
那大部分的情况之下，他们并不能看到屋内的情形。
And what they can see is our door. They can see our doorposts.
但是他们能够看到我们的门框。
They can see our gates.
可以看到我们的可以看到我们的门。
So in other words, as Christians, we should not only be Christian when we inside the house or inside the church, we must be Christian also outside the church.
所以对我们来说，就是我们不单单只是在教会里面要做一个基督徒，我们离开了教会，我们也是基督徒。
You know, for me, before I came to know Jesus Christ, I have very bad temper.
那对我来说，在我认识主之前呢，我的脾气不太好。
And I also have road rage.
那我很容易发怒。
I even follow a couple of people home because I want to hurt them very bad. This before Jesus Christ. I even follow people, when I'm driving, people, they're like, give me the finger or swore at me. I even follow them home because I want to hurt them.
那有的时候在我认识主之前，在开车的时候，如果别人对我有不友善的表现，我甚至会尾随他们回到家，因为我想要伤害这些人。
But can you imagine I do that nowadays? You know, when I'm with my family, people beep at me or give me the finger, and then I get so upset and I swear and I curse. How can I glorify the name of God in that way?
但是试想，如果是现在，当我的家人和我一起在车上，如果有人又对我有不友善的态度，我也这样的回应的话，那我要怎么样能够来荣耀神的名呢？
So in other words, when you and I want to teach our children,
所以换句话说，如果我们想要教养我们的儿女，
not only behind closed doors, we also teach them when we're outside in the public.
那不单单只是在门后，我们在外面，在公众的场合，我们也要教养他们。
Do our children see that we have grace, we have love, we have compassion toward other people in the world.
那我们的儿女是不是可以从我们的身上看到我们对他人是有爱、有怜悯跟有恩典的呢？
Or we act just like Gentiles who are in the world without, you know, putting the word of God, you know, on our doorposts or on our gates.
那或者是我们所言所行就像外邦人一样，我们并没有将神的话放在我们的门框、我们的门上呢？
Now when we put the word of God on our doorposts, on our gates,All our neighbors who walk by, they know and they see that we are Christians.
那如果我们将神的话放在门框跟我们的门上的话，所有的邻舍经过，他们都会看出我们是基督徒。
Then we put the word of God on the doorposts on the gates, And when you and I come home and when our children come home, we can't wait to go inside, because if outside, you know, there's the gates, the doorposts have the word of God, for sure inside even have more wonderful things.
所以如果在我们的房屋的门框还门上都有神的话，那我们会迫不及待的想要回到家，因为我们的家中必定有充满更多的神的话语。
So, you know, let's think a little bit about this.
那让我们再更多多的来思考。
As we quarantined with our children.
那在我们现在和我们的儿女一起隔离在家的时候。
Now, do our children love to spend every minute with us now that they are home? Are they...No, they, you know, they always want to be apart from us when they are home. They want to go in their rooms. They just want to be by themselves.
那我们的儿女是不是在这一段特别的时间，他时时刻刻想跟我们在一起呢？还是说他们只是想要关在自己的房间里面呢？
So maybe if they don't want to spend time with us, and then we must take more time to spend with them.
那如果他们不想要花时间和我们在一起的话，那是我们要踏出这一步，花时间和儿女在一起。
Because now that they are home, they are quarantined, they have no choice but to stay home with parents. And if they choose to spend every second with us, this means, you know, they really can see Christ in us.
那在现在这个特殊的时间，那他们没有选择，只能待在家里。如果他们愿意时时刻刻跟我们在一起的话，代表他们在我们身上真的看到耶稣基督。
Or they cannot wait, you know, they feel they cannot wait to go back to school so they can spend time, less time with us, right? That's not a good thing.
那如果他们是迫不及待的想要赶快回到学校的话，那或许对我们来说这不是一件很好的事情。
But whatever it is,We hope that every single one of us have a quiver full of arrows.
但是无论如何，但愿我们每一个人都能够拥有这个充满箭的箭袋。
And we know each arrows, you know, have different characteristic, you know, different material and different usage.
那我们知道每一支箭，它有不同的特性，不同的材质，有不同的功用。
And we know that very few arrows.You know, that you take up and then it's automatically very straight. Very few.
那很少会有箭一拿出来它就会非常锋利的。
So that's why as warriors, we need to shape the arrows, right? We need to put inlay in it. So, you know, so we can make it more effective, you know, for parents and also most importantly, more effective in the eyes of the Lord.
那所以我们作为勇士我们就要能够来让我们的箭变得更锋利，那就好像做父母的，我们要能够教养儿女，让他们成为有用在神面前有用的人。
And if you and I be able to, you know, have a quiver full of arrows, and the smell of the arrows, the aroma itself attract people, that would be very wonderful.
那如果我们有充满箭的箭袋，并且这些箭呢都是蛮有香气，可以吸引人的，那会是很美好的一件事。
Of course, heaven's beautiful aroma is only part of it, but if the beautiful aroma, you know, the arrows cannot be useful, you know, useful for the Lord, and then it's useless.
那当然，能够拥有香气只是一部分，但是如果这个箭不能够为主所用的话，那它也是没有功用的。
So may the Lord help us.
那愿神帮助我们。
And for those who will join us for a bonding fellowship at 3:30, we'll continue to study, the quiver full of arrows.
那其他那些在三点半要加入在丰盛团契的弟兄姐妹，我们会继续来查考这个充满。
Now let's rise up and sing hymn 359.
那我们现在一起起立唱诗359首。
359
首。Thank you.
Amen. I praise and thank God.
感谢赞美神。
Now let's just kneel down and pray together and ask Heavenly Father to guide us.
那我们现在再一起跪下来祷告，求天父来带领我们。请一起跪下来祷告。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. We praise and thank God. We just concluded afternoon service.
There's
no announcement, but for those of us who are joining for the Abundant Fellowship, we'll see you at 3:30.
那我们在这里没有任何宣布事项。那要参加丰盛团契的人， 我们待会下午3点30分再相见。
And grant you peace and joy.
那愿神祝福大家，
If God is willing, we'll see each other soon.
那如果神愿意的话， 我们很快又可以再次看到大家。
Thank you, Sister Sophie.
愿神祝福大家。